Okay, I'm Larry Maddox. I'm here to help my refugee friends and all other people that need help, especially those that are trying to get their test for the Utah driver's license written test. Those that can't read, this will help them. I'll just read this for you. And when you get to the test, they will help you. That will give you a headphone so that you can listen to the questions. If you are a refugee, you can have someone speak, translate the questions into your language. If you are not a refugee but an immigrant, they make you, they don't give you a translator that will go in and help you translate as you take the test. But they will give you the headphones, and you can. I think they can give you the questions in English or Spanish, but not Arabic or Dinka or whatever. But if you're a refugee, they will give you a Dinka translator or Arabic or whatever language you speak. Anyway, so here are 40 test questions that we're going to take. And as we go along, these will fill in. And sometimes I might get one wrong, but it'll show you immediately what the right answer is. So here goes. Here's the first question. And they've got a picture here. You're parking next to a curb facing uphill. Which way should you point your front wheels? So here's, I guess apparently this is facing uphill. It's hard to tell. Which way you should pay, you should point your front wheels to the left. Where does it say left? Well, away from the curb. So that's the left. In this case, the curb is to your right, and you point your wheels away from the curb. Let's you point your wheels away from the curb. That's green, so we got that right. Next question. You may pass another vehicle if there is blank next to your lane. I'm going to just try to quickly find the right answer and not read these because at some point we need to just go through these questions as fast as possible. And if I'm talking too fast, YouTube has a thing where you can slow down what I'm saying so that you can understand easier. If you need me to talk slower, YouTube will slow it down. So a double solid yellow line. No, it's not that. A dashed. If there is a, it's got to be a dashed line. So we're going to go with a dashed white line. Let's try that one. Nope. Yeah, a dashed white line. Also, a dashed yellow line too. You may pass another vehicle if there's a dashed yellow line. Anyway. On a two-lane roadway, you approach a school bus displaying alternating flashing red lights. What should you do? Come to a complete stop. Next question. What does this sign indicate? The right lane ends ahead. A sign with black letters or symbols on an orange background is a work zone sign. If you approach an intersection at which the traffic lights are not working, you must first blink before entering the intersection and then yield right of way. If you approach an intersection at which the traffic lights are not working, you must stop before entering the intersection and then yield the right of way. Come to a complete stop. Next question. In Utah, when you parallel park your vehicle next to a curb, your vehicle must be within how many feet of the curb? Oh gosh, I don't know. Let's just go with 12 inches. Yep, I got it right. The area of the freeway beyond the solid white line is meant for parking, emergency, stopping. It's emergency, right? Yeah. In Utah's business districts, the maximum speed limit is what, except where otherwise posted? It's 25 miles an hour in Utah's business districts. Okay. What does this sign mean? This sign, you know, it's a picture of a truck. This is a truck with a line through it. That means when there's a line through something, it means no. So here it means no trucks are allowed on this road. In Utah, which occupants of a passenger vehicle must wear safety belts or appropriate child restraints? Everybody! The driver and all passengers. If your vehicle stalls on a railroad track when a train is approaching, what should you do? You need to get out and get away. You don't try to restart. Get everyone out of your car and then just get away. Get away from there. What does this sign mean? See, you can barely see this. That says stop. You must come to a complete stop. The area around your vehicle where other vehicles cannot be seen in your mirrors are known as a blind spot. Opposing lanes of traffic are separated by, you know, I think it's yellow lines. Got to be yellow lines, right? They don't even show what those lines are. I guess they don't want to show the answer, but it's yellow lines. What does this sign indicate? This is a phone. That used to be what phones look like, you know. Before you were born, they had phones that looked like this. What does this sign indicate? A phone. When you approach a stationary emergency vehicle with flashing lights, what must you do? Well, I'll just find the answer here. Slow down, move. Okay, slow down, move into a non-adjacent lane if possible. Adjacent means a lane that is next to another lane. So, yeah, move into a lane that's not right next to the lane where the emergency vehicle is. Okay, next question. This sign indicates this guy holding a flag means a flagger is ahead. This sign indicates RR. What would RR mean? It would mean railroad crossing. Where is railroad? Railroad crossing. What does this warning sign indicate? This warning sign is, to me, that's a school zone. Is that not a school zone? Playground ahead, a school zone, or school crosswalk ahead is what I'm gonna say that. Yes, I'm right. Because all these questions are green, that means I've got them all right so far. You're driving on a two-lane road. If the road is too narrow to make a U-turn, you may make a three-point turn, four-point turn, single-point turn, or a four-point, a single. Anyway, it's a three-point turn. They always say three-point turns. Even to me, they're just two-point turns. The answer is always three-point turn. Three-point turn. What does this sign indicate? 444. It means you are 444 miles from the state line or the end of this road. If a tire blows out, you should Keep your vehicle going straight. On a two-lane road, you have moved into the opposing lane to pass another vehicle. You must return to your original lane before any oncoming vehicle comes within how many feet of you? I never can remember this. I'm going to say 200 feet. Yeah. Under Utah law, you must not use the opposing lane to pass another vehicle unless you can return to your original lane before any oncoming vehicle can come within 200 feet of you. Note, at higher speeds, even 200 feet is cutting it rather close. Suppose your vehicle and the oncoming vehicle are traveling at 45 miles an hour. The two vehicles will close a 200-foot distance in only 1.5 seconds. Therefore, there is a head-on collision. At higher speeds, you shouldn't use the opposing lane to pass unless it will be clear for even longer distances. I have a friend that died because of that. Someone was trying to pass and they didn't get into the other lane quick enough. By the way, we are in an easy test. This Salt Lake Community College that does these, and that have made these, and then there's like easy, and then hardest, and then a simulator. Anyway, right now I'm just doing this one easy test. We're on question 25. In a roundabout, you must just find the right answer. Go in a counterclockwise direction. Is that a counterclockwise or a clockwise? No, it's a counterclockwise direction. Let's click here. Yep. Freeway driving can lead to highway hypnosis, a condition of drowsiness or unawareness. You can avoid this condition by shifting your eyes frequently. Next question. If two or more vehicles arrive at an intersection at about the same time, the vehicle on the left shall yield the right of way to the vehicle on the right. Okay. On a highway, the left lane should be used for passing. The left lane should be used for passing. Under Utah law, you must dim your headlights whenever you are within how many feet of an oncoming vehicle? Let's say 500. I can't remember. Let's guess 500. Yes, 500. Under Utah law, you must dim your headlights whenever you are within 500 feet of an oncoming vehicle or within 300 feet of a vehicle you are following. In Utah, it is recommended that you leave a following distance of at least how many seconds behind the vehicle ahead of you? 2 seconds. If you have entered an intersection to turn left and the traffic light changes to yellow, what should you do? So you're here to turn left. Traffic light changes to yellow. Then turn left. Just do it. Next question. What occurs on wet roads when your tires start to ride on the water instead of the road? It's called hydroplaning. Next question. In Utah, effective December 30th, 2018, an adult driver can be charged with driving under the influence, DUI. Driving under the influence is a DUI if his or her blood alcohol concentration is 0.05% or higher. When you stop your vehicle at a railroad crossing, you must stop at least how many feet from the nearest rail? I don't know. Is it 2015, 10, or 5? I'm gonna go with 10. Or is it 15? I know I'm gonna get this wrong. How many feet is 10 feet? I've gotten them all right so far. I don't want to get one wrong. Let's see. Let's go with 15. Oh, I got it right. I can't believe it. Okay. What does this sign indicate? It looks like it means that there's going to be a divider coming up. So, a divided highway starts ahead. In Utah, you must switch on your headlights if you cannot see how many feet ahead due to fog, stormy water, dust, or darkness. I'm going to go with 1,000 feet. In Utah, fines for speeding in a work or a construction zone are doubled when workers are present. What does this sign indicate? Some merging from the left. That's what I'm saying. Merging from the left. Oh, the right, not the left. I got one right. Merging from the right. That's your right. Okay, so merging from the right is what that is. I'm trying to go too quick. You must not use blank to exit a freeway, even in a traffic jam. You must not use an entrance ramp to exit a freeway, even in a traffic jam. In Utah, the maximum speed limit on interstate highways is like 80. So I got finished. We only missed one. And it was just a stupid miss. So, when you take the test, you can review your answers. So that if you don't pass, before you hit the submit button, click on the review of your answers to see what you got wrong and see, I think it shows you what the right answer is. So here, I can go through all of these and look at these again. On this one, the one I got wrong, what does this sign indicate? This is the right. Someone's merging in from the right. Merging from the right. Anyway, I'm gonna try to make some more of these tests. Maybe I use the hard stuff to, and there's a simulator also that but you can go to I'll put a link of where these sample tests are in the notes. Okay, good luck.